the fossils of possibly the largest snake ever and the weird corporal placement of Neolithic buried bodies have garnered attention from around the globe and brought to light previously unknown information in the fields of paleontology and archaeology. Over the past month, there have been remarkable findings that are significantly advancing our understanding of history. Join us on this captivating journey following the groundbreaking discoveries of April 2024. For some time now, it's been confirmed that humans formerly shared Earth with other human-like species, and recent DNA tests have pushed forward the theory of interbreeding. This mixing of genes across species shows a common past and gives insight into the migrations and interactions of ancient populations. In 2012, Russian scientists uncovered a large fragment of bone in Denisova cave, situated in Siberia's Altai Mountains. The bone, studied under the guidance of Samantha Brown from the University of Oxford, belonged to a teenage girl, lovingly christened Denisova 11, or Denny. She was roughly 13 years old at the time of death, 50,000 years ago. DNA tests indicated that Denny was a direct child of two unique human species, establishing her as the first known hybrid. Her mother's DNA connected her to Neanderthals, a population prominent throughout Europe and Western Asia. Meanwhile, her paternal heritage was unmistakably Denisovan, a poorly recognized population that resided in East Asia. The ramifications of Denny's presence are considerable, revealing a higher degree of connection between Neanderthals and Denisovans than previously accepted. This interbreeding is also demonstrated in current human genetics. Europeans and Asians have roughly 2% of Neanderthal DNA, but up to 6% of the DNA of current Melanesians stem from Denisovans. Another noteworthy instance is that of Uaza 1, a modern human who lived 37,000 years ago in what is now Romania, yet had a Neanderthal ancestor only 4 to 6 generations before. Anthropologists are also shocked by recent unearthed evidence that implies a possible connection between the rituals of ancient human sacrifices extending back thousands of years in Neolithic Europe to present forms of punishment used today. In a pioneering investigation, evidence around sacrificial rituals was unearthed at Saint-Paul-Trois-Châteaux in the Rhône Valley, France, placing primitive punishment practice between 4000 and 3500 BC. The archaeological team, headed by Bertrand Lutz from the French Research Institute on East Asia, uncovered the bones of three women in strange positions. The first lady was discovered lying on her left side near the middle of the burial place. The other two ladies were positioned beneath an overhang, one on her back with a grindstone on her head and bent lower limbs, while the third lay prone with her neck resting on the thorax of the second lady. The victims looked to have suffered from forced positional asphyxia, a horrific procedure where the victim is pushed into a position that obstructs breathing, leading to ultimate death. This arrangement implies that the latter two ladies could have been subjected to homicidal ligature strangulation, which can be presently linked to the Italian mafia's phrase incapretamento. This method uses a rope that is knotted around the wrists, ankles, and neck of the victim, resulting in a slow and agonizing death. Historically utilized by organized criminal organizations as a form of punishment for traitors, it acts as a violent manner of retaliation and a sharp message to others. This relationship between ancient sacrifice procedures and present-day criminal tactics gives a fascinating insight into the continuity and development of human behavior towards punishment and intimidation. Despite the chronological gap, the psychological, anthropological, and cultural repercussions remain profound and continue to echo throughout criminology today. Subscribe and enjoy our monthly news updates that explore the depths of human history and its continued effect on present culture. Let's move on to the field of paleontology, where the amazing discovery of a 76 million-year-old fossil is transforming our understanding of marine life from the dinosaur era. In a spectacular discovery in Mexico, an international team of paleontologists uncovered the fossilized bones of a massive marine species connected to the present great white shark. The find happened at a limestone quarry in the northeastern portion of the country, and the fossils date back to the Cretaceous era. This extinct ancestor of the great white shark is estimated to have reached up to 30 feet long, dwarfing today's great whites. The species, a member of the mackerel shark family, belonged to the genus Pacodus and is notable for its huge teeth and fierce bite. These traits imply it was a durophagus, or shell-crushing shark, arguably the biggest of its type to have ever lived. Fossils of Pacodus are commonly discovered in Cretaceous marine deposits worldwide, frequently consisting mainly of vertebrae, teeth, and incomplete dentitions. However, the Mexican site gave us a rare view into a more comprehensive anatomy. The near-complete fossil discovered enabled scientists to recreate possible features of its appearance, nutrition, and movements. Impressions of eye sockets, fins, tails, and even internal organs were preserved unusually well in the platy limestone, a kind of sediment noted for its rarity in entirely preserving shark fossils. The study's principal author, Romain Vullo, from Geosciences Rennes, pointed out that such well-preserved fossils are very unusual owing to the precise circumstances required. Calm, murky waters with few scavengers. This find consequently constitutes one of the rare cases where a nearly intact shark from the late Cretaceous has been reported. Interestingly, these sharks are likely to have targeted hard shell species like sea turtles, with their food preference perhaps leading to their demise owing to competition with other marine predators that acquired similar appetites. In a separate study on current great whites, researchers equipped sharks with trackers to watch their habits in different California waters. The data suggested that great whites are very adaptive, demonstrating diverse behaviors based on their surroundings. Notably active between dawn and dusk, where fish food is more available. Both results illustrate not only the intriguing development of these predators over millions of years, but also the incredible ability to adapt to varied ecological niches. Sharks' existence can be traced as far back as 450 million years ago, meaning they were 190 million years before dinosaurs. Paleontologists are scratching their heads around a recent discovery that has them questioning the snake species with the largest size ever. Paleontologists uncovered several remarkable snake fossils at the Panandro Lignote Mine in Gujarat, India, which borders Pakistan. These bones reflect a previously undiscovered ancient species, believed to have lived roughly 47 million years ago during the warm Eocene epoch. The finding of 27 snake vertebrae, each measuring roughly 1.5 to 2.5 inches, let experts estimate the snake's imposing size, which could extend from approximately 36 to 50 feet in length. Named Vasuki indicus, this species represents the largest known snake from the extinct genus of Matsoid. Comparatively, the largest snakes today, the reticulated python and the Burmese python, reach lengths of 32 feet and 19 feet respectively. Debai Datta, a paleontologist from the Indian Institute of Technology, Roorkee, and the author of the study, emphasizes that this finding not only expands our understanding of the Matswali family, the ancient lineage of snakes that persisted for around 100 million years, but also enriches our knowledge of snake diversity from the Cenozoic era in India. Moreover, the gigantic size of the Vasuki indicus shows the tropics during the Eocene period were likely warmer than now, since bigger poikilotherm species, like snakes, tend to correspond with greater ambient temperatures. The research further implies that this snake was part of a larger Matsoid group that originated initially in the Indian subcontinent before migrating over southern Europe and Africa. But the bigger question remains, could the Vasuki indicus be greater than the Titanoboa, formerly considered the largest snake ever? Titanoboa, which lived from 58 to 60 million years ago after the dinosaur extinction, attained lengths of up to 50 feet, mostly because of the warm temperature that maintained its size and cold-blooded nature. While the data shows that Vasuki was somewhat shorter than the Titanoboa, data highlights the potential that the biggest Vasuki individuals have yet to be identified, allowing the opportunity for conjectures that it might have been substantially bigger. The discovery of the Vasuki indicus not only adds a new chapter to our knowledge of ancient existence, but also encourages a re-evaluation of ecological and climatic circumstances in historic times. Join us next month as we continue our journey through historical excavations. Until then, check out our videos on the amazing discoveries of 2024 that are revolutionizing our understanding of the past.